un coup d'œil à une application et deux prototypes qui poussent à l'enquête. Ça passe tout à l'heure, c'est le premier. Peut-être pas publier les abstracts, ça vous aura une interface pour les applications. Un petit dégâts, pas du temps à un premier approche et il y a un petit fond d'accent. It has been designed from the als Charakteristik der Mobilität, die Gesamtmobilität bei 11% bei der Testaktor. TIS Specification ist just gehört. Jetzt wird sie gegen den Mentor und dann eine richtige Pipo-Chance und Proton kostet die Sachen, die sie mit dem Mentor an die Sachen mit dem Mentor. Und dann mit dem Mentor in diesem Testis Thank you. time given series to the metric rate, and then using the top tick for the parameter in such time to the top tick series to the top tick score. Here, the URL of the API resource that we are retrieving in the first request. Then, every time the server will push a new update, a JavaScript function will be triggered, and you will be able to access to the data that has been sent from the server to the client directly in JavaScript, and you will be able, for instance, to update it to your application. If you want to subscribe to several topics in one time, you can use several query parameters, several topic query parameters, and then you will get all the updates for the bit/1 or the review/21 topics. Basically, the topics can be any identifier, but if you use intermediate API, it will be the ID of the API resource that you are fetching in the first part. You can also use some kinds of buttons in this product syntax. Here, it means that we want to add the update for every resource matching this button. So you choose the URI template specification from the IETF. To publish some data from the application server from your API to the clients, to the web, it's very easy to just add from the server to the web that you broadcast the update automatically. You just have to send the post request
same format that we're giving you, shipping you today, with cloud computing, the data organization look. Some events of qualified support is the authorization method for some example events. It's not because of the native implementations of browsers. To publish, there is another example again. If you want to publish private data, then you dispatch only to clients having the back of your targets. You have to add a target to, and it contains the targets that are authorized to receive this submit. And that's all. This kind of is really the natural but very good option of broadcasting the targets only to the authorized clients. Except that Mercure has also been, the support for Mercure has also been introduced in a data platform. So, there is all this framework that basically you have to describe the public data structure of your API, of your API resource, as a PHP class. A PHP class with something like this, and that has some relation with the other resources, the other classes of the API. Then you map it with the API resource annotation. Then you can map it with a persistence layer using the program. And that's all you have to work in order to get more of the API for this data structure. And then add some code to customize the behaviors. But basically, it's all you need to get a proper web API with the right web documentation to give you the support and so on. If you want to add Mercure support to that, and if you want API platform to automatically push updates from this entity, for this resource type directly to the clients every time a new resource is created, a resource is updated using a put query, or a resource is deleted, you just have to add a flag in the Mercure, and then you can add a generic of the Mercure support of API platform. API platform has also front-end components, client-side components that are able to create an administration interface or to scaffold progressive web apps and native mobile apps for Vue and for React. They are easy to use, you just have to open them to run and they work with any API supporting the hybrid or GCNLD formats, even if they are not writing retail PHP, even if they are not using the server side part of API platform. And they will generate front-end applications using the hybrid documentation. Basically, you can get this type of application automatically just by typing two things. Here is a React application, and here is a React Native application that can be downloaded to App Store or Google Play, for instance. And we, those applications, those generators, also support if you need the native support. So here is what you can do. For instance, you are on your web app and you change something. You push on the submit button. Every client that has been connected to the website and that has fetched this API and opened an event subscription to this API are automatically updated. And it works with this way, so if you change something from the web app, then automatically all the applications, including the React application, are automatically updated. And the worst case is when someone deletes something that is currently displayed on the screen on another device, then the application generator detected and had a display warning on the mobile app or on the server side application. So it's very, very easy to use the API platform that actually the Mercure protocol is totally standard and can be easily implemented in any programming language, with any framework, with any JavaScript tool to use. Thank you very much.